लोग आ रहे हैं, हर एक को टेस्ट कर रहे हैं, किसी को ना तो नहीं बोल रहे हैं। सवाल यह है कि जिस किसी को इस किस्म का शक होगा, कोई लक्षण होगा, तो खुद आगे आए और दवाखाने में जाके खुद।
महाराष्ट्र, तमिलनाडु, गुजरात एंड दिल्ली कंटिन्यू टू बी द वर्स्ट अफेक्टेड स्टेट्स इन द कंट्री।
नॉट राइजिंग एनी मोर and this would happen from geography to geography, city to city, and state to state, and district to state, because we are a conglomerate of large number of a very large population and a very large geography. So yes, on the whole, two things have happened, that the trajectory has been slowed for sure, that's a fact. At the same time, we are still on the rising curve. Also remember that when we entered into lockdown, a measure that was timely and early, at a very opportune and a calculated moment. We were in the early phase, and therefore, it is expected that the epidemic will take a little time to stabilize, unlike other nations which came into picture with such measures, such as a lockdown on a large scale, at a much later stage. But they had already faced the devastation in terms of loss of lives, and there was already a huge disruption of life, and lockdown became a necessity. The country went into lockdown in a planned approach to combating the pandemic.
Right, Ms. T. Rajeshwari is also with us. She is Additional Secretary, Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Ma'am, we were talking about if we had not locked down earlier, we would have been staring at much, much higher numbers, and we did lock down on time. But in terms of numbers, ma'am, how do you think we have averted the crisis?
Yes. So actually, different modeling studies are undertaken to help, decision making as far as health policy and disease control are concerned. Based on the available data sources, primary and secondary data, whatever available data, different modeling studies are undertaken. Now, there are many studies undertaken by different agencies. The Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation and the Indian Statistical Institute jointly have undertaken a study based on the available data, and also the considering the fact that the exponential growth of the COVID cases. So on the basis of this result study, it has been estimated that we could avert around 20 lakh cases, and deaths we have averted around 54,000 cases. So overall, considering all the study, with 95% confidence, we can say that between 14 to 29 lakh cases have been averted, and around 37,000 to 78,000 deaths have been averted. So we are on the right track. So we are fully confident that with the lockdown measures that has been adopted, and the various social containment, like containment measures like social distancing and others that have been advocated, and people with full cooperation, public cooperation, we are on the right track, and this has reached rich dividends also.
And you think the numbers would have risen if we had not locked down?
Exactly.
On time?
So this has been a very the decision to undertake to impose lockdown has been taken rightly by the government, and due to which we could avert the large number of these cases. Otherwise, it would have been a different picture altogether. So this is what our study has revealed, and this is based on whatever available data. And also, if you see the exponential growth of COVID cases, so this is what we have added, and we are on the right track. And with all these measures, and with the public awareness that is now, we are on the right track.
Okay, Ms. T. Rajeshwari is saying that we are on the right track. But Mr. Paul, what do you think? How are we placed now? Too early to ask you, but when do we see zero cases in India and India being free of this disease?
Well, as we move forward, one of the very important effect and the result of the lockdown is not just about numbers. It's also about how prepared the nation is. If you above all look at the preparedness on the part of people, you just now showed a clip which showed how people, simple people in the marketplace, are adhering to the guidelines that are healthy guidelines. They prevent infection for themselves as well as for others. And you see the compliance of guidelines that are put at the macro level in terms of how our conduct should be in offices, in workplaces, in trains, and so on and so forth. So this is a huge behavior change. And actually, it is more than behavior change. It is actually a very major, very effective, very deep Jan Andolan, which is building up to combat this pandemic. This is also an achievement of lockdown. When the numbers remain in control, we could manage the numbers, we could manage the patients, we could confine it to localized areas and had all the time to raise awareness. And look at the preparedness on the health front, for example. Today, there is a provision of 3.2 lakh COVID care hospital beds.